Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. Nice to see you back, and we are here with April, the most electrifying month of this year. Lots of changes during the month of May, and therefore this April month is very crucial because by mid of May, three planets are about to go retrograde: Venus, Jupiter and Saturn. And Mars will be retrograde towards the later part, the end of this year. And therefore, this is the month where we need to really make sure that we take the right actions, because if we take wrong actions during this month, then we might regret later during the mid of May, from May 15th. Alright? So therefore, this month is very crucial, and I have decided to do the screen recording so that you can exactly know how the planetary energies are shifting and how they are changing. And there you go, we have the horoscope for 1st April. It's already 4th today, so the month started with this is a Aries ascendant chart I have put. Anyways, doesn't matter. So sun is around 17 degrees of Pisces. The moon was in Gemini. Ardra Nakshatra, then Mars had entered Capricorn and it had just crossed Saturn. If you see, Mars is at 650, Saturn is 632. Mercury 21-27, Mercury has started its direct motion after retrogression. Then Jupiter had just entered Capricorn, so, and Venus had just entered Taurus. So Mars, Jupiter, Venus, these three have changed signs, alright? So, of course, the limelight of this month will be the sign of Capricorn, because there are these three planets, and if you take Western astrology, then you can also consider Pluto there. So, if you see, Pluto is in 0 degrees and Jupiter will be heading towards Pluto, and I guess currently when we check for 15th, it would have already crossed Pluto. Alright, so let us discuss these energies today, and as usual, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it below, and if you want a consultation from me regarding this month for your career or marriage or health, you can go to the website down in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. Alright, so we always start with sun. So sun has entered this Revati Nakshatra. So therefore, Revati Nakshatra is very important when it comes to showing mercy to others. Alright, and Revati is related to Pusan, who is the person who protects animals. He herds animals basically, alright, he's like a shepherd. So therefore, you would have noticed that from some time, because Revati is the last nakshatra, so it is in the beginning, the first pada of Revati, 17 degrees of Pisces. So therefore, from the time sun had entered Pisces from 15th March, you would have noticed that many people have been inquiring to become a vegetarian because they have seen how deadly diseases come out from eating meat, and just for the satisfaction of the tongue, people are killing animals and they are eating. And now these people in China, they were eating bats, and some say even cockroaches and many other animals. And nothing against China or Chinese, very clear with that, no discrimination, no hatred against them, but we need to learn the lessons. Okay, so we should not hate somebody who has done sin, as Jesus Christ said, hate the sin, not the sinner. Alright, so we should not blame the Chinese unnecessarily, like many people are doing. But it is for us to introspect and realize that their actions have led to very severe blunders throughout the world. Either it's China, America, and or Europe or India. In a sense, there is no difference between killing a bat or a cockroach or a chicken or a goat or a cow. It's all the same, of course. So those countries who are blaming China that they ate these bats and because of these diseases came out. So many people don't know that there has been many other diseases which has come out before also from different countries. Okay, another disease was this mad cow disease, which comes out if you eat beef. So therefore, in essence, long story cut short, we should stop blaming countries or a particular group of people. And we have to understand that this is not a country-based call. This is a universal call for humanity to wake up. All right. So if we are in India or we are in Europe, we are in US or we are in China, and we continue to indulge in these degraded activities, then we will suffer. And today it's coronavirus, tomorrow it will be some other virus. So therefore, this Revati Nakshatra is a call, and now Sun has entered and Sun is in Revati now. So now is the time you should make a decision to become a true vegetarian, to not kill animals. All right, civilized human beings cannot eat meat. So anybody who eats meat is uncivilized. He's like a dog who is just going around roaming, doing nothing. Okay, he's headless. He has no compassion, basically, and he will have severe karmic consequences. Nature will not spare him. He will be punished. God will punish him very badly. Why? Because you are killing his animals. Imagine a father who has two sons, and one son says, "Oh, actually, you know, my dear father, I want to kill my brother because so that I can take all my property." Then what will the father do? He will just give him a tight slap and he will put him into prison, right? So this is exactly what God does. So all the crooks who are eating meat, they will suffer now or in the future. Now this does not mean to say that those who are vegetarians, they won't suffer now, okay? If you are careless, you will still suffer. But the point is, humanity has to wake up and give up their audacity and stupidity in the name of this jingoism, eating animals all around. And yes, luckily many people are waking up, but there are some idiots who are still sleeping in the slumber. They think that, yeah, we can still eat meat, we can still do whatever we want. Well, wait and watch. You will pay the price one day, all right? If not in this life, then in some other life. So it's your choice, all right? Then let's go to the energies of Mercury. So Mercury is in Aquarius. It had crossed the retrogression and it started its direct motion some time back. So therefore, people are becoming more and more aware of the world and how the world is moving around, basically. And because it is in Aquarius, it's a friend sign, so people are having this healthy sense of communication with each other. But some time later, Mercury will enter the sign of debilitation, which is the sign of Pisces with Sun after some time. So during that time, people may feel that there is a sense of urgency for communication which they are not able to fulfill. So therefore, there might be a sense of panic. So it is important that we don't panic, and unnecessarily we do not blow things out of proportion. So when Mercury transits water signs, it can happen that we are blowing things way out of proportion than it should be blown. So we should understand that everything that is happening in this world is a part of nature's signals towards us, okay? So humans, out of their audacity and stupidity, they have destroyed Mother Nature, and now they are paying the price. And now these big politicians, presidents, prime ministers, chancellors of countries, they are crying, they are shouting, they are hogging, they are bubbling, and they are jumping, and they are blasting on everybody, and they are saying, "Oh, our economy will be stop, this will happen, that will happen." Well, this is what you have done, so now you must pay the price, all right? So therefore, when Mercury enters Pisces, it is a good time for us to really reflect on our decisions that we have taken. So this is a very harmonious energy with the Sun in Revati, all right? So it is a good time for us to make the right decisions. And yes, many things which I am saying in this video, you may not like it. You may want to hear nice things. Oh, it's virus time. Why are you spreading fear? Why are you creating terror? you are an idiot, you are a rascal, you are stupid, you have no knowledge of astrology, you can say all this, but I will still end up saying what I want to, alright. Now, Mars has entered Uttarashada Nakshatra. So, Mars and Jupiter and Saturn, all three are in Uttarashada, if you see, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn. So, I was talking to somebody yesterday she was telling me that she was having a conversation with Amanji, Aman Bedi of ABA, Aman Bedi Astrology. Amanji is very famous. So she was telling me that suddenly in India they have started telecasting these serials, Ramayana and Mahabharata. So Ramayana and Mahabharata is quite related to Uttarashada, and she was telling me that Amanji had explained even in my channel when he came that opposite nakshatras always play the role. So if you see these degrees, at least when Mars was in initial degrees and Jupiter, so Punarvasu is directly opposite, Punarvasu and Pushya. Okay, so Punarvasu theme is coming out. Punarvasu is the nakshatra of Lord Ram, Pushya is the nakshatra of Bharat Maharaj, who is his younger brother. So these things are coming around. Punarvasu is return of the light, something which is very old, 30 years back these were telecasted in the 80s and 90s, these things are now coming back. And Uttarashada is related to war also, so there is the theme of war in both Ramayana and Mahabharata, you can very clearly see that. And this combined with Revati, people are realizing importance of true culture, true Vedic knowledge, and because Mercury is in Aquarius, so people are able to accept it also. So yeah, there are some people from certain communities, certain sections of the society who are not happy with this also. So they are saying that these things will spread Hinduism or will make people more religious or make people anti-Islam, anti-Christian, anti-Jewish or something else. So this nonsense is going on from long time. So let them keep speaking whatever they wish to, but those who are civilized and intelligent and those who know what Ramayana and Mahabharata stands for, they know what's the importance, alright. So do not pay heed to these idiots, let them keep barking, let them keep shouting, let them do what they want, alright. So that's none of our business, let them keep shouting, and they have been shouting always and they will always be shouting, alright. So don't listen to them. And she was telling me, the lady was telling me yesterday that she has been watching around 3 to 4 hours of this Ramayana and Mahabharata TV serials in India, in Gujarat. And she's having the time of her life, alright. So therefore, if you can use this Revati energy, letting go of things, focusing on divinity, not killing animals, and then this Uttarashada, Pushya, Punarvasu theme of understanding the divinity, understanding Lord Ram, Lord Krishna. So therefore, you will really have the time of your life now, alright. And Venus has entered Kritika Nakshatra. So therefore, you would have seen that many people have started posting photos and videos in WhatsApp and Facebook regarding things which they are cooking. I have heard some coffee has become very famous. So yeah, that's how materialistic society works. When they have nothing to do, they will indulge in food, wine and sex. So now Venus has entered Taurus. So perfect time for materialistic society. We even degrade and go down to the level of animals, okay. So they will do whatever they want. So they will, maybe they will eat more meat, okay, and they will ruin their lives. So yes, Venus is in Taurus. Taurus is the original sign number 2. It shows food and drinks, but at the same time understand that you should use this lockdown period properly, okay, and not just waste 8 hours a day cooking and just eating, inventing new dishes. Well, you can do that, but then you will get into depression, because if you eat too much, then you will have too much sugar in the food and too many carbohydrates. You might eat excess protein also sometimes. So then this lockdown will be more miserable. So already you are miserable, so don't make the lockdown more miserable by eating too much sugar. All right you can eat more vegetables. Vegetables will give you more potassium, sodium, then this it will give you calcium, magnesium, Right, so these things will really help you. So eat more vegetables if at all you want to eat. If you want to cook, then cook sattvic food and eat how much ever you want, okay? But don't just make whole day about eating, okay? Because then you will end up cursing yourself, you will curse God, you will curse the government, you will curse the prime minister or the president. Why there is this lockdown? Why cannot go outside? Because you are frustrated inside, right? So don't become more frustrated. Everybody is already frustrated, but let's be disciplined when it comes to eating, okay? Otherwise, because there's a proverb, you are what you eat. So if you are eating crap, then you will become crappy, okay? All right, so eat good food and utilize your time properly. So now let us go to this 15th. Okay, so we have the chart from 15th here. So then we realize that this Mars enters Shravana Nakshatra, and then Mercury has entered Pisces 12 degrees and Sun has just entered Ashwini. Alright, so during this mid half, it is very crucial that we, because see, when Sun enters Ashwini, it's a very good time because it's the sign of exaltation, okay? So therefore it's a very important time that we try to focus on the things which actually will give us a lot of fulfillment and happiness, okay? So therefore, when Sun enters Ashwini from 15th, it's a very good time to do exercise. It's a very good time to be productive. It's a very good time to work on your business idea if you want to write a book. Instead of sitting in home and just eating 8 hours a day, sleeping 8 hours and watching TV 8 hours, instead of wasting 24 hours like this, you can write a book, you can read the scriptures, you can read the Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, and then you can see that your life becomes much better, okay? So currently you may be feeling this drowsy energy of Pisces till 15th, but after 15th you will feel that you are becoming more and more active, okay? So you can do Surya Namaskar. When Sun enters Aries, doing Surya Namaskar is a very good option. Don't waste your time, okay? And 15th is a very crucial day also, because Moon will be joined Mars, Saturn and Jupiter. So very crucial day, okay? So during 15th you can expect major changes, major government decisions. And therefore, because why I'm saying government, because this Capricorn represents the original 10th sign, which has to do with authority, okay? So many countries may change their decisions, or they may continue their decisions or make some changes within that, alright? And wherever Capricorn is, it will be a very intense house for you during that time, alright? And Mars has entered Shravana Nakshatra, and therefore you will see the houses which Mars rules in your chart, they are undergoing some kind of a settlement, alright? You can see and let me know in the feedback what happens after 15. Shravana is the nakshatra for settlement. And then Saturn is in Uttarashada, of course, with Jupiter. Jupiter is hovering around Capricorn also. It has been in the sign of debilitation. And therefore, it's crucial that we chant this mantra, Om Namo Bhagavate Shri Vamanaya, till the time this Jupiter is in debility, okay? And Mercury has entered Uttar Bhadrapada Nakshatra, and then it will enter Revati after some time. So therefore that energy is also very good to focus on your spiritual practices. Uttar Bhadrapada is related to Ahirbhudanya. He is the sea serpent. So sea serpent means focusing on your inner energies, your kundalini, your inner meditation, inner power, inner progress. So Mercury transiting Uttar Bhadrapada can be a great time to read the scriptures, read about Surya Namaskar, read about Pranayam, read about things like Kumbhak, read about Nadi Shodhan. These are great opportunities which you will have, alright? So don't waste your time and utilize it properly. And Akshaya Tritiya is also around the corner. I will make Akshay Tritiya video some other time. Okay, not now. Okay. And Venus is continuing to be in Taurus. And yes, Rahu Ketu is hovering around in the last, sorry, not Ketu, Rahu. Rahu is hovering in the beginning degrees of Ardra. And very soon in May, he will be entering Megashira Nakshatra. Okay, so I will make that video later. So now let's go to 30th April. Okay, and yeah, one thing I forgot to say that this full moon will be there. Okay, full moon in the Pisces Virgo axis. So Pisces Virgo axis will be very crucial for you, and the new moon will be there in Aries. All right, so therefore Aries and this Virgo Pisces axis is extremely crucial for you. So, and the month ends with some challenges, of course. Again, the moon is under this aspect from Jupiter, Mars and Saturn. So this can create some challenges during the end of the month, but you will still feel that because of Jupiter's aspect, there is some relief, and Sun will continue to be in Aries and it will enter Bharani Nakshatra. Okay, somewhere around 27th around, it will enter Bharani Nakshatra. And therefore when Sun enters Bharani, you may feel that there is this slowdown which is becoming even more prominent. So some other states, some other countries might also declare lockdown during this period. Okay, so therefore Mars has entered Dhanishta by that time, and Jupiter has slowed down. It is about to go retrograde after some days, and Venus has entered Mrigashira. So people will feel, when Venus enters Mrigashira, then people will figure out newer and newer ways to meet people, maybe online or, you know, by Skype, or home office things will become more and more prominent. And Mercury would have entered the sign of Aries, Ashwini. All right. So therefore, the end of the month is a bit crucial, and please stay at home. Do not go out. And you should realize that safety is most important, health is most important, and focus on your spiritual journey. By that, you will see that this lockdown which is there can be used in a better way. Okay, so change your diet, take to vegetarianism, and stop killing animals, stop behaving like barbaric human beings, and don't waste much time watching this Netflix and all the useless stuff. And yeah, most importantly, panic and fear. Okay, TV channels, news channels, every day they are reporting, one person detected in Himachal Pradesh, one detected in Maharashtra, one detected in Washington DC, one detected in Melbourne. So what is the use of knowing all this? Every moment one patient is detected here, there, all the useless rubbish, garbage. So we need to take precautions, and we need to make sure we give good input. Okay, so watch good things in the internet. Okay, don't just keep hovering around these news channels, otherwise they will ruin your mental peace. You'll feel that the entire world is going to be destroyed. Okay, and at the same time, don't think that everything is okay, things are fine. No, things are not very good. Astrologically, it can get worse also. So understand that. So instead of taking, panicking and creating fear for yourself and others, understand that things are difficult now. And later on it may change. So take the necessary precautions, eat good food, stay with good people, improve your relationship with your family members, improve your married life, improve your health, and learn new things, learn new technologies, so that when this corona crisis is over, you can bounce back in your career. Okay, online schools, you can go to Coursera.org, Udemy.org, Udacity, Unacademy. These are so many websites where you can learn. Okay, you can learn anything. You can learn painting, singing, dancing, or programming. You can learn business, anything you can learn. All right, So use this time productively rather than cursing God and the government for this lockdown, okay? So understand that whatever has happened, God is not the one who is arranging all this. I mean, yes, he is sarva karana karanam, he is the cause of all causes, but it is because of the karma of the human beings, we ourselves, that we are suffering, okay? So we should not waste our time blaming God, because that will not solve any problem, any of the problems, because we are the ones who created, okay? So we should take enlightenment from the scriptures and learn things and then move ahead, alright? Thank you very much, and wish you all the best for this lockdown period. So utilize this properly, don't panic and don't take things casually. Don't go out unnecessarily unless you need groceries or it's a medical emergency, only then go out, or if you are under essential services. And my thanks and my respects to all the doctors, nurses, physicians and the pharmaceuticals and all the police and all the paramilitary forces who have been working tirelessly to help humanity in this hour of need. So thank you very much. This is all what I can say, and whichever country you are residing in, the government would have made certain rules. Like in India, there is this lockdown declared by Prime Minister Narendra Modi till 15th April. So please follow the lockdown, otherwise he will extend it. Alright, so don't take him cheaply. And even in some other countries, like I'm in Germany, the state where I am, in Bavaria, Bayern, there is lockdown, okay, for many days. So then please follow the state rules and state laws. Don't behave whimsically, otherwise the police will catch you and they will hit you and they will rip you apart, okay? And that is something which the police should do also, unless you are going out for some medical emergency or buying groceries, okay? Thank you very much, and God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him.